You know, now, rumor has it, I mean, everything's going to work out, but the guys in Chevelle are under the weather, feeling the flu. Is that true? Is everything working out?
Yes, it's true. We're sick.
All of you guys are
Although sick. I'm working on this voice for, like, sort of a, you know, sexy kind of a thing.
Dramatic effect.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that. But actually, let's all sit down. I don't want to.
Lovely.
I feel uncomfortable.
Standing.
So how have you guys been, man? It's been a little while. You know, actually, real quick before you start,
yeah.
I remember when you guys first played Earth Day Birthday and you were the curtain jerkers. You guys are the first people on the list to play.
Yeah, it's nice to move up, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really nice. And you guys always put on an absolutely fabulous show. I mean, it's always good to have you here. I mean, you're part of the JRR family.
Yeah.
Lots happened in the last couple of years. More albums and better times, huh?
Yeah, no, it's been really, really good. Yeah, the sick thing is, like, it's what it is. In fact, you're going to want to Listerine this mic once I'm done.
Well, I ain't going to use it.
What do you got, like a flu sort of thing?
Yeah, the Canadians call it beaver lung.
What?
Beaver lung? Lauren's like, I'm listening. I'm all ears.
Wow. Yeah. But it's just a throat thing. He was sick last night, and he sang great, and he'll just try and fight through it today. But, you know, you can never not do a show. It doesn't matter if you have no voice at all. You still got to sing.
Stand up there and sign the lyrics.
Yeah, sign the lyrics. Sign that's
language.
Right.
Yeah.
You just got to make people sing louder. Then it's better.
I haven't talked to you guys in Chevelle's, you know, it's been a little while, and it was actually right before the changes in the band.
Yeah.
Can you kind of explain that to us? I mean, I'm not trying to pry, but I am curious.
No, it's fine. It's not like it's a weird thing for us. Our brother Joe was with us for 10 years. Since the time, well, he was 14 years old when he started with us.
Yeah.
So you got to figure, he did it for so long, he was so sick of it. So all the little things became big things. And eventually kind of what happened was he just said, I don't want to do certain shows anymore. So you're gonna have to find somebody to replace me for what I don't want to do, and we were just like, you know, that's stupid.
Yeah.
Either you're gonna do it all or you're not. So it's what it is.
Kept in the family though, right?
It what?
You kept in the family though, kind of, right?
Yeah. I mean, without a doubt, Dean was really our only choice.
Right.
You know, he was always there. We've known him for so long. We've been friends for like 14 years. He's married to our sister. We have that.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, how does that take place? I mean, come up to say, Sam, listen, look. You know, it's just not going to work out. I mean, and then was there like kind of a tip? I mean, because, I mean, you guys, it's cool to have the family and the band with all you guys being brothers and whatnot.
Yeah.
And then one of you has to leave. You're like, you're going to screw up the whole damn thing.
Well, yeah.
That's why I said I don't want to pry.
I am curious.
It appears you're prying.
Geez, how does that work out? Basically, I'm not even sure how to say it. We never talked before. So having all that happen, it wasn't really that much different, you know. He was a pretty unhappy guy. Anybody who, has seen our shows has seen that he was always like the person who was kind of really quiet. He didn't want to do anything.
Sure, yeah.
Didn't really like to be on stage. You know, he's my brother, and I love him, and I'm not saying anything bad about him. But the fact is, when somebody doesn't want to be a bass player in a pretty successful rock band, people think there's something wrong with him. But
yeah.
You got to figure it's just not everybody's life.
Well, you got to deal with listeners and, you know, fans and people that
that's a good part.
Constantly want to be around you. And if you're not that kind of
person. I think it's the traveling that killed him.
Yeah?
Yeah, he just wasn't a good traveler.
We just go around to people and say, oh, he's our special brother.
Well, you know, it's like it's a nomadic lifestyle. It's, you know, it's a gypsy lifestyle. So you have to sort of want to camp for, you know, a year at a time.
Yeah, I mean, how long are you guys generally on the road? 10 months out of the year?
Yeah, I mean, this year, yeah, it'll be a little less than that because we didn't start until March. So, but yeah, we'll be on the road through December.
That's gotta suck. I can't imagine being on the
road. No, you know what, man? It does not suck. It's actually a ton of fun to be able to play your music. What is our art? To be able to go out and do that every day is, it's amazing. And I'm not hanging drywall, so
right.
Bonus.
Or digging ditches, right?
Or digging.
Actually, it's funny. You remember the band Saigon Kick?
Yeah.
Yes. I tell the story all the time. The guy, lead singer for Saigon Kick. Last I heard, he was putting floors in my mom's old house.
Yeah.
Yeah, did I tell you that story?
No.
Yeah, he's like, he used to be a leader, lead singer of a rock band. And like, my mom's like, pretty big band. He's like, yeah, huge, you know, he's playing huge arenas. Like, this band side
yeah.
Kick. By the way, where do you want the trim?
Right. Did he at least do a good job on the floor?
Yeah, he did a great job.
He rocked it.
Maybe he was just bored and needed something to do.
Ah, bored, funny. It was wooden floors.
I don't think he was trying to be funny.
I
but it worked.
I talked to Buzz from Disturbed. He was
sure,
for Disturbed. And he was like really rich before that band ever happened. So when he left that band, he went back to buying buildings and rehabbing them and stuff.
Really?
So he actually does this kind of like a similar thing on a bigger level.
Something like that, because, you know, Buzz did leave Disturbed, you know, this was years before the happened with you guys. And you being from Chicago, like the guys at Disturbed, you go to Dave and say, hey, look, Draymond, how'd you handle the situation?
Yeah. Did we go to him? Is that what you said?
Yeah, I mean, do you look for advice? Because he's,
we did. And he was actually really helpful. In fact, we thanked him on this record for that one very thing. But, you know, when it's brothers, it's different, I think, a little bit. But it all got worked out. I think it'll smooth out later on.
You asked Draymond about Buzz, and he wants no part of it, really. I mean, to be honest, he's
no, I think he said, he was like, I think those guys are just like oil and water.
Yeah, definitely. We'll talk about the new album, man.
Love it, by the way.
New song's great. You know, it's good stuff flying around.
Okay.
We keep forgetting you're sick.
No, I'm fine.
Have a couple beers, you'll be all right.
Use some honey, some lemon, hot tea.
This man of Budweiser and some Hooters Girls.
Yeah, that all sounds good.
That sounds everything.
The new record's called Venus Era. It's 11 tracks of what I hope is humbling rock music.
Sure, yeah.
Dude, my favorite is that Gucci Clan.
Oh, really?
Awesome track, dude.
That's funny, too, because we changed the name of that song. It's Bad.
Okay, because so I have like the master demo before the album came out, and that's what it was called on that.
Yeah, no, that's great. We just changed it because we didn't want anybody to have the Gucci name at all.
You didn't want to get sued by Gucci?
Yeah, bring it on.
Okay.
Bring it on. Bring it on, Gucci.
I'm so over trying to be a careful person in the rock business, you know?
Right.
Like, that's not cool at all.
PC is not rock star.
It's not rock star.
Not at all.
And you guys remember, I mean, years ago when you know, we're talking about you guys kind of curtain jerking the Earth Day birthday.
Yeah.
You remember that, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, because, I mean, I don't want to get into it, but there's a lot of things. I mean, you will always remember this radio station.
Oh, yeah. Well, for so many reasons.
Exactly.
Something happened that I'm not privy to.
No, it's just an us thing, man.
Okay.
We just want to make sure our friends and Chevelle always remember WJRR, and we take good care of them. We've got good personnel around here.
Okay.
Is that what you call it now? Taking good care of them?
Taking good care of them.
Yeah, you know what? There's not a lot of shows like this across the country. Like, if you talk about big festival shows, you know, radio stations, I think, like, there's not a lot of good ones.
No. So. Yeah, I mean, we do it.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, and you know what? Our listeners make it. I mean, this is just such a fun event. And when
it is.
And when you pack all of the JR listeners in the lineup, like we put on each and every year, and you guys, you know, obviously, when we ask, like, you guys, they say, hey, guys, shut up, you play it. You guys jump on it right away. We don't have to wait around for you guys.
Oh, no. Yeah, we always want to be part of it. It's great. And actually, tonight, I think we're, like, second to last.
Yeah.
So, we really have to step it up.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's 4 years since you curtain jerked, I think. So now you're second to last. That's just how it works.
That is nice to see that you do progress with year to year.
So you guys gonna get some rest before you go on? Your set time is 8:30.
I'm gonna start drinking and like.
Dude.
Nice.
That's the best way to do it, brother. I'm telling you.
Well,
it kills all the germs.
Yeah, we do gargle with Crown.
Jack Daniels.
All right. Listen, man, we're looking forward to, again. Do you have the exact time that Chevelle will be up on?
8:30.
8:30.
Yep.
All right, and it's sold out, man. We've been sold out for about a month now.
Yeah.
And it's always great to see you, my friend. Hope you get better.
Oh, thanks so much. We'll be fine.
Yeah, okay. Good. The double stage, like you like it.